It's John Hanson, and this is WGN Radio's Your Hometown. And today we are in Joliet. We got a lot of things to check out. We're going to learn a lot along the way and also give back on this holiday season. And of course, it's snowing here today in Joliet because it would only snow on the day that we chose to film. It's cold, but that's okay. We're going to have a great day in Joliet. So let's get to it. Joliet has such a cool, rich history, a lot of it tied to the fact that it was a steel city. It was integral on the Route 66. It's got gorgeous churches, historic mansions, great parks, even a really cool greenhouse, a preserved ironworks site that's now part of the Forest Preserve. It's just a city with a good beat on its past, its present, and its future. So we started our visit at the Illinois Rock and Roll Museum on Route 66, which is all about celebrating musicians, bands, radio shows, and personalities all with ties to Illinois. It's not meant to only be a place for memorabilia and things to look at, although they do have a lot of that, but really an interactive experience for a new generation of rockers.
Well, we're sitting in the theater down here where people can come in and actually perform. We have performances down here. This is also used for education, so we've been here for about 4 years now, and the community is really nice. The downtown was the place that just bustled back in the day. Now there's a synergy that's happening downtown that's incredible. There's a lot to do downtown Joliet now.
And speaking of music and performances, we also stopped by the Rialto Theater, which is just beautiful. It was originally built in 1926 as a vaudeville movie palace, as it was called. Parts of it was designed after Versailles, which you can totally tell, and it was restored in the 1980s. It continues to dazzle audiences and attendees. It is so cool. And just around the corner, I had to stop by the Joliet Area Historical Museum and Route 66 Welcome Center downtown. It's a celebration of the city's history. I was really impressed. Kind of feels like a big city museum. Greg says that it attracts a lot of people from all over the world.
We have a great deal of interest from international visitors who are typically doing Route 66. The feedback we get from those guests are, when we ask them, why are you doing this? We typically hear, well, this is the real America. So there's an authenticity behind Route 66. There's a lot of history behind Route 66.
And we stopped by when the museum was actually closed, but Greg was so nice to just let a few people that were peering in the windows come on in. We met a couple from Arizona and also a growing family from the Netherlands that are on a start of a Route 66 road trip. So for a long time, Joliet, I know a lot of people knew it as the city with the prison from Blues Brothers. It's certainly way more than that. And in recent years, now really 2 decades after the prison closed, they've started to embrace a bit of the idea that people are interested in checking out the impressive building. So Greg, who you met, actually gave us a little behind the scenes tour, some of which you can see on the public tour, some of which really freaked me out. I don't like empty prisons, especially when it's just me, Greg, and producer Curtis. But I could see why people really get into the history and also start an important conversation about incarceration in the United States. It's a real eye-opener, and I couldn't wait to get out of there. But if that is your thing, please go check it out. It's really cool. So I'm not much of a gamer, so when Curtis told me that our next stop was a virtual reality spot, I had to admit I was a little skeptical. But this place is so darn cool. Honestly, I've never done it, like put on the goggles and stuff, and it really did transport me to another world. It was exhilarating, it was fun, it was scary, it was just really cool. They're a homegrown Joliet business. They've got all these big screens so other people can watch what you're watching. They've also got 300 games to choose from. It was really awesome. Rent it out for birthday parties. Stop by, have some fun. And the cool thing is they're already expanding with more locations opening up. And if you want to franchise a place like this, just chat with them. And who knows? It could end up being one of thousands of locations around the country, just like Dairy Queen, which, oh, by the way, the first one was in Joliet. We should also mention that while we were in town, we joined the folks at McDonald's on Hobolt, just off of I-80, for the 21st annual Food for the Body and Spirit Turkey and Trimmings giveaway. 300 full Thanksgiving meals distributed the morning we were out there. Great work, really great around the holidays. Okay, so that was a busy and fun-filled day in Joliet. I learned a ton. I saw a lot of great places, and I think you should give Joliet a visit and check out some of these places and plenty more. Till next time, I'm John Hanson, and I can't wait to visit your hometown next for WGN.